Are you looking to grow your remanufactured medical device business but are not able to capture market share in the U.S. because of competitors like GE, Philips, or Siemens? And are you now thinking of expanding into China but are not sure how to do it and what risks you might face? We at Good Enough Consulting have the answers to your questions. We'll get into the risk factors and give our recommendations later, but let's first get a picture of what the Chinese market for medical devices looks like. China's one-child policy resulted in a major shift of the population demographic. This graph forecasts the percentage of China's population over the age of 60 in coming years. In 2000, it was 10%. 25 years from now, this number will rise to 24%. In 2050, this number will grow to an astonishing 32%. This represents a significant potential demand for medical devices catering just to the elderly. Right now, 80% of the population is in the rural areas. Today, China's middle class totals less than 100 million people, but within the next 10 years, this figure is expected to grow to more than 200 million people. China's GDP has experienced double-digit growth from 2003 to the present and grew by a whopping 10.7% in 2006. Driven by both spending and exports, the GDP growth for 2007 is 11.5%. China's GDP as a percentage of world GDP is rising. Right now, it's about 15%, but 10 years from now, it'll grow to 25%, and it is expected to be 36% by 2030. China's healthcare industry is also growing. Looking at the compounded annual growth rate from 2002 to 2006, it's booming at 14.9% annually. The annual growth is projected to still be a very high 11.1% by 2011. With so many potential patients, how does the Chinese medical device market look? Estimated at $13 billion and growing approximately 15% annually, the Chinese medical equipment and devices market is the world's third largest behind the United States and Japan. Imports account for approximately 70% of China's $6 billion medical device market, and the U.S. supplies approximately 35% of those imports, followed by Japan and European countries. China has the potential to be the largest single country export market for U.S. medical device exporters. China currently is the second largest medical device market in Asia at 34%. There are significant opportunities for U.S. firms in the middle market for advanced yet competitively priced equipment. The market penetration of basic medical equipment in China's hospitals is very low compared to developed countries. There is a need for affordable technology that Chinese manufacturers cannot yet offer. U.S. products are highly regarded in the market and are viewed as being of superior quality and technologically advanced, especially for large equipment such as CT, X-ray, and MRI apparatus. Now, let's evaluate the eight risk categories, starting with government. Government, risk, regulating agencies. Since 2003, all manufacturing, import, and distribution of medical equipment is regulated by the State Food and Drug Administration of China. A registration certificate is required before these devices can be sold. Redundancy, along with non-transparent policy changes, have created uncertainty in the process. This results in significant delays for companies registering or re-registering products. Recommendation: it is highly recommended that companies wishing to enter the Chinese market authorize a local rep or specialized agent firm to manage the registration from within China. Risk: forced expansion westward. This brings positives and negatives. The positives include cheaper land and cheaper labor, while the negatives include increased transportation and shipping costs. Recommendation: companies can hedge this risk by setting up a joint venture with a local firm and leveraging the trade routes and knowledge of the local infrastructure. Companies can also learn about the local infrastructure by established relationships with government officials, both local and national. Supply chain risk, infrastructure breakdown. Although China has spent a great deal on infrastructure since the 1980s, the country's infrastructure is far from meeting the needs of its large, geographically dispersed population and industry. Recommendations: do not centralize customer service operations. Hire local engineers to refurbish designs to mitigate infrastructure developments. Risk, location. Freight costs have risen fivefold since 2003. Inland transport costs to the coast from inland provinces are often higher than overseas transport. One reason is the high cost of moving goods through the many toll roads. Recommendation: shorten the supply chain in order to reduce cycle time and disruption. Use freight derivatives to control future shipping costs with increasing demand. Political triggers. Risk: tariffs and potential trade war. Don't get caught entering the market at a bad time. Recommendation: be cognizant of relations between world leaders and events. Take advantage of opportunities such as low tariffs when exporting. Economic risk. High inflation will make long-term service contracts riskier and reduce real income. Recommendation. Since the strategy is to make money from service contracts, the impact of inflation is high. Write contracts with clauses to protect against inflation. Risk. Currency exchange. The dollar may continue to fall and China may lift its peg. This will make it more expensive to buy equipment with dollars. Recommendation. Avoid converting back and forth. Use Chinese revenue rather than financing in dollars when making capital purchases. Human resources. Risk. Chinese companies have a difficult time retaining employees due to better work environment or career opportunities elsewhere. Recommendation. To protect the company's trade secrets and competitive position, use non-compete and confidentiality agreements. These are enforceable in China. Golden handcuffs. Also, use alternative benefits to attract or retain key employees. Under a golden handcuffs program, a company can subsidize a portion of the manager's education in exchange for years of service following graduation. Intellectual property, risk, IP leakage. The threat of local low-cost alternatives can reduce a firm's service revenue stream. Recommendation. Utilize a customer service rotation program using college student interns or new engineers from the U.S. Risk, reverse engineering. Third-party manufacturers may make copies of your machines. Recommendation. Create locking systems such as ID badges on the devices to prevent access to info without authorization. Environment. Risk, natural resources and pollution. China has a scarcity of resources and contamination of water, air, and soil. Recommendation. Adhere to environmental regulatory requirements and best practices. There is an increasing political willingness of the Chinese government to enact and enforce these regulations. Cultivate a green reputation with the government and press by public works in addition to your own normal operations. Culture. Risk. Corruption. Delayed product launches due to slower regulatory processes for ethical companies. Also, bribery may be rampant. Recommendation. Consistent emphasis of corporate integrity internally and externally to preserve face or mianzi, which is respect of an individual as a consequence of his or her social achievement and practice. Form partnerships with universities, hospitals, and research institutions and practice facework to benefit the local community. Use facework to build good guanxi with key officials to circumvent corruption and mitigate unusual regulatory delays without resulting to bribery. Risk. Work and cultural values. Beware the culture clash. Recommendation. Worker input should be sought individually to avoid the possible loss of face. Practice facework to build good guanxi. Give more structure and explicit direction. Close supervision is needed even with good guanxi. Here is our assessment of the different levels of potential risk for entering the Chinese medical device market. Finally, we recommend that you should bring the remanufactured medical device industry to China, use local assets to manage regulatory and registration processes from within China, write service contracts with clauses to protect against inflation, to mitigate poor infrastructure, decentralize customer service operations, utilize proprietary locking systems to prevent unauthorized access to medical devices. Require non-compete agreements with ex-employees. And most importantly, work with cultural values to maintain good guanxi. From everyone at Good Enough Consulting Incorporated, thank you